Welcome to the Honestips Arena, the main stage for the first Robot Toys Olympics 2018. Other robotic competitions evaluate the humans who build and program the robots, but we don't do that. These Olympics focus on the robots themselves and the amazing things they can do. Ladies and gentlemen, here are our 10 athletes who will be participating in these Olympics. Which one will be the fastest? Which the most maneuverable? And which one perceives the world around it the best? Now, we've created a series of events to discover the most exceptional robots. And among the competitors, we have small and big robots with wheels and tank treads, famous and unknown robots. In short, we have a really interesting variety here. Most important, every one of them is a real robot, which can be programmed and bought on Amazon for less than $200. Now we see the opening ceremony with the lighting of the plasma globe, which marks the symbolic beginning of these Olympics. In this first video of the Olympics, we'll see day one of competition with two events, max speed and up the hill. The first is max speed. The robots must complete a course with two obstacles and then cross a finish line. The robotic toy that can complete the course in the shortest amount of time will be the winner and prove to be the fastest, most maneuverable robot. They have to run through the course, and we record their lowest time. For the final round, only the two fastest robots will race against each other. After eliminating 8 of our 10 participating robots, the two finalists are Spark, a robotic ball, and the famous astromech droid R2-D2. We are ready to start. Get set, go! Spark takes the lead. R2-D2 does not want to be left behind, but Spark's advantage is notorious and easily wins the race. Spark is by far the fastest. Look at how it handles the turns with such grace. Wow! These are the positions after the first event with their lowest times. Top 5 finishers score points. Now we go to the second event called Up the Hill. Robots must climb a ramp with variable angles until they cross the finish line. The robot that manages to climb the ramp with the steepest angle will be considered the most powerful robot with better traction. All robots climb the ramp. For the final round, we'll see two of the most powerful robots compete. The robots with tank treads were superior to those with wheels, and that's why the finalists for this competition are Jimu Builderbot and Cosmo. The finalists rush onto the ramp, try to climb. Cosmo is easily reaching the finish line. Can Jimu Builderbot match it? The ramp at 34 degrees is so hard. And Jimu Builderbot slips and goes down. Cosmo wins. Cosmo can climb an incline up to 40 degrees. It's amazing how this little robot has so much power. Now we see the positions after the second event with the maximum angles that each robot could climb and their respective scores. This is the scores table at the end of day one of the Olympics with the sum of the scores of the two events. This is the end of the first day of competition. Visit us at honesttips.com to learn more about these great athletes and other robotic toys and to find out how these events were done. Thank you very much for watching, and we'll see you next time.